Hello Pisces, this is Debs and this is your reading for mid-July 2022. Pisces, I hope you're well. Let's get straight into this, Pisces. I saw in a vision someone signing a document and then I heard with a flourish. Now, to me, the words with a flourish sounds creative. So I don't know whether or not one or two of you have moved into a situation where you are being paid for work that you've done. So if you are a creative, whether or not this is movie making, photography, whether or not this is a modeling contract, whether or not this is some of you maybe publishing your first book, you may be signing a contract with a flourish. There is linked to this vision, or there was linked to this vision, a sense of excitement. Now, I've got to be honest, it could be that for some of you, you're getting out of a marriage. Maybe you're signing divorce papers and actually really glad to be out of this. It could be for others of you, you're signing on the dotted line because you've got a new lease on an apartment or a house. Maybe for some of you, you're buying your first place. Maybe for some of you, you're getting a new job and you're really excited. There's something here, Pisces, relating to signing on the dotted line. For some of you, this could even be you signing off a project, feeling as if you've done really well. It could be you signing a certificate, I don't know. But this is a very important time in your life, Pisces, because you may feel as if you reached some kind of goal and now you're thinking about the next goal. I've got to be honest, Pisces, I don't know if this is love. It may not be. It could be you reaching a milestone in your career. It could be you getting to a point where you can finally move into your own place. Whatever this is, you're on to the next phase is what I'm feeling with you guys. Okay? All right. Let's jump in, see where this goes. Here we go. Using an angel oracle to help me connect through with Source. The deck is, of course, the Gilded Tarot, Ciro, Marchetti. Very interesting. I'm hearing someone say to themselves, I can't wait to get started. This is really exciting energy, Pisces. Really exciting. I can't wait to get started. Okay. All right. Wow. Don't know what this is. Archangel Michael, thank you for joining us. This is the reading for my Pisces. This is mid-July 2022. Mid-July 2022. Thank you, Michael. I'm hearing Archangel Samuel, Archangel Ariel, Archangel Uriel, Archangel Metatron. Thank you, Michael. Oh, Arnold is with me. He says he's going to sit very quietly in the corner and read his paper. He's not going to disturb me. Okay. Cedric is with me with Edward, his bunny. Mm-hmm. Okay. You guys must think I'm crazy sometimes. Here we go, Pisces. Ooh, Father Carey is coming through. Very interesting. He's opening up a book of what looked like checklists, like a checklist. And he's ticking off a second box. The first one has been checked. This is the second box. Okay, thank you, Father. All right. The Chariot, Cancerian energy. Now, this is movement, this is travel. For some of you, you may be relocating. This could be very exciting. You could have signed on the dotted line for a new place and a new job. For others of you, you may have undertaken some kind of trip and you've come back full of inspiration. Maybe inspiration for a book, a painting, a poem, a film, whatever this is. Definitely creative energy or inspired energy. You've also made a choice, Pisces, to move forward and not look back or not stay stuck. I have to say, though, that it's been after a period of long deliberation, or a period of waiting for something to close out, to finish. Okay. Eight of Swords. There's a little bit of nervous energy in moving forward. For some of you, just a little message, for some of you, you may have ended things with a Cancerian, or you could have Cancer in your chart, Pisces, and you're on the move. There is a sense of fear. There's the energy of, oh my goodness, I can now move forward, I can progress, I can do what I planned on doing because I've closed out some kind of chapter, I've achieved a goal, but I'm a bit nervous about the next phase. I'm a bit nervous. Bless you, Pisces. Okay. In the past, the Page of Swords, there might have been a difficult message of truth. You could have connected to someone online. This could be factual information. You could have received a message which was somehow linked to you being able to move forward. For some of you who are single parents, there could have been emails going backwards and forwards about a child. With the Strength card, after that time, you needed to have the courage and confidence to hold your head high and to tame your primal instinct, is what I'm hearing. Whatever that was, maybe to jump forward before you were ready, maybe to hold back from some kind of temptation. I mean, if you received money in, it could be you holding back the temptation of spending too much. You could have received a difficult message of truth from a Leo, very simple for some of you, and you needed to have the courage and confidence to move forward after that difficult message of truth. Okay, Pisces. What you're thinking about is the Ten of Cups. Now, this is a beautiful, wish-fulfilled, happy home environment. For some of you, you may be purchasing your first home. You may be moving into a new house. You could be going for your dream come true. I don't know why. For some of you, you may be getting an interior designer in to completely redo your home after divorce. For some of you, you may be adding on an extension to your house. I'm hearing architect's plans. So this is a general message, guys. So it could mean different things for different people. But you're very excited about whatever this forward movement is, and you're thinking about the Ten of Cups, whatever that is for you. Wow, guys, what is going on? Ten of Swords? Okay, Pisces. So Pisces, the Ten of Swords is a painful ending. For some of you, you're moving on after realizing that something had to come to an end. There may be a sense of betrayal. Now, for some of you, if you're getting out of a long-term situation, you will feel successful in doing that, very excited, signing on the dotted line. Whew, I'm home free. I'm going for my Ten of Cups. But there may be a little bit of a backlash, almost just as you leave. You know, it's a sense of you walking out of a situation with your head held high as if, yes, I've achieved, I've won, I'm leaving, I'm ending this, I'm moving forward. And then somebody kind of tripping you up as you go through the door. So you land on your face. It could be a little bit of a nasty backlash from someone who is angry with you, upset with you. Somebody who almost is sitting in a bit of revenge energy. You may feel a bit betrayed, Pisces. But there is a sense that in general terms, you've got two tens here. You are definitely moving forward. Okay. What you're fearful of is the King of Cups in the reverse. Now, Pisces, I may be connecting with a masculine Pisces. If so, you may be fearful that if you were at all a little bit manipulative in the past, you may not get all you want in this new phase that you're going for. If I'm connecting with my female Pisces, my little feminine fishes, it could well be that you are coping with the ending of something that was painful. It may be that you felt you were strong enough to deal with this ending, but it might be that there's a little bit of a painful gash that you have to deal with. I'm almost getting a spiteful message. It may be, Pisces, that you block someone because with a difficult message of truth, you realize someone was holding back. Somebody might not have been telling the truth. You may have moved on, and whoever this person is may have been sitting in regret. You may have pushed them back. They may have tried to approach you again. You might have pushed them back very strongly. And it may be that just as you feel the situation is over, you get a really unpleasant text, you know? Could be vengeful, could be spiteful. It may knock you a bit. You may think, oh my goodness, that was really unnecessary. But you may just have to cope with it. You could have been dealing with somebody a little bit manipulative. Maybe a fellow Pisces, Cancer or Scorpio. Wow. In the environment, Pisces is the Queen of Swords. So whoever you are dealing with a feminine Aquarius, Libra or Gemini. Now, I could be connecting with a masculine Pisces. I'm feeling that energy. I've got to be honest. I feel as if I'm connecting with somebody who is ending a situation to be in the Ten of Cups with somebody else. But whoever that somebody else is may have questions. Questions, Pisces. And due to those questions, you may face a shocking ending of a situation that you had hoped to develop. Gosh, it's unfolding. After this conversation, what you're hoping to do is to not do anything else that's risky, to hold back from anything risky. Or after this conversation, you may decide to let go of an Aries. The outcome is the Magician. You're manifesting, I'm hearing, a peaceful, calm life, Pisces. You could be manifesting an Aquarius, Libra, or Gemini. Or you're moving into a very powerful energy. Five of Swords. Okay, yeah. Three of Swords in the reverse. Queen of Cups in the reverse. You've got the King and Queen of Cups. Nine of Swords in the reverse. Okay. Underneath the deck, King of Pentacles in the reverse. Okay. All right. Underneath that, Knight of Pentacles. Very clear message, Pisces. Okay. Yeah. Two of Swords in reverse. Seeing the truth, someone making a decision. So Pisces, what we have here, and it could indeed to do with signing some kind of contract. What we have here, Pisces, is someone, and this could be you, I feel, who is sitting in a little bit of fear, but deciding to reconnect with somebody that they'd known in their past. Very strong soul connection, King and Queen of Cups. I feel that I'm connecting with a Pisces masculine. Bear with me, girls. You may also be a Pisces feminine. So we could be dealing with a Pisces masculine and feminine, or a Pisces masculine potentially connecting with an Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, or a Cancer or Scorpio woman. This masculine Pisces has decided after a lot of deliberation and a lot of fear to move towards someone that they consider their Ten of Cups. But the problem is that I don't feel that this masculine Pisces has ended another situation. They may be trying their luck. So Pisces masculines, you may be trying your luck in connecting or reconnecting with someone that you have on your mind. But you may still be in a situation with somebody else. Now, it could be very complicated. You know, there are so many different versions of a third party. Maybe Pisces, you are in separation from your person and you know you're going to head to divorce. But before you divorce, you're heading towards somebody that you're hoping to have the Ten of Cups with in the future. Something like that. But whoever this Queen of Swords is, I think she is going to speak her truth. She's going to be a little bit cold and a bit defensive. And you may feel that what you had hoped to achieve, you're not going to be able to achieve. Stay legally married, but separated from your partner, and have a beautiful live-in Ten of Cups with this Queen of Swords. I.e., you would keep yourself financially stable, but you would be living with this woman that you feel is your Ten of Cups. I think she's going to say no, Pisces. I think she's going to say no. And it may be that you have to face a very painful ending. Now, what I then feel is going to happen is that you are then going to realize, Pisces, that if you really want this Queen of Swords, you are going to have to totally detach from the person that you're still connected to. Divorce. Potentially, or selling the house that this person is living in, completely detaching from any legal or financial responsibilities, if you want to be with this Queen of Swords. So I feel we've basically got a masculine who, in the nicest sense, is going to try his luck. It may be for financial reasons, okay? It may be because to break a contract that is legal, maybe marriage, there would have to be financial loss, and this man doesn't want to have to go through that. I mean, in all fairness, not many people would want to do that. So what he's doing is he's coming forward to this Queen of Swords to say, look, I'm still legally married, but I am in full legal separation from my ex-wife. We don't talk anymore. We don't live together anymore. She's not in the area. I'm hoping that's enough for you to say, yes, I want to live with you. But obviously, of course, we can't marry because I'm legally married to somebody else. I don't think this woman is going to accept that, Pisces, but I do think that there's a strong indication that feeling so disappointed that this woman says no, that you, masculine Pisces, are going to actually decide to do the right thing and to take control of the situation to completely sever that tie. So guys, we have our story, okay? End of reading. There's a lot more involved, I'm sure. Let's just delve into this. Pisces, we've got the Chariot in the reverse. Now, you could have been dealing with a very unbalanced Cancerian, you masculine Pisces, okay, that maybe you've decided to move away from. They could live a distance. Or you're deciding to travel towards someone. You could be deciding to travel towards a Cancerian, but you're very nervous about their response. But there's travel involved. Definite travel involved, okay? In the past, with the energy of the Page of Swords, there was a very difficult message of truth. This could have been an email, a message, there could have been a child involved. Whatever this difficult message of truth was, you had to have the courage to tame the lion within, to hold your head high, and to have the confidence and the courage to just move forward. You may in the past have been holding back from someone that you met in the past, but it took a lot out of you. This is somebody that you may have met that you felt, this is my person. So if you knew this Queen of Swords before, she could have sent you a difficult message of truth to say, Pisces, I have feelings for you, but if you're still in a relationship with another woman, I'm not interested. And you had to hold yourself back. You could have wanted to move towards a Leo. What you're thinking about now is that I feel you are partway through dissolving a long-term situation. So you may have gone halfway house. You may have thought, okay, well, we've legally separated. We're not living together anymore. My partner knows that we've legally separated, but we're not actually divorcing. There could be lots of reasons for that. And what you're thinking about is the Ten of Cups. I want to be emotionally completely fulfilled and happy. I want to have a brand new life. And I feel, Pisces, you are moving towards someone that you have very strong feelings for that might have put up boundaries in the past. So, Michael, when have we got the Ten of Swords in the immediate future for my Pisces, please? End of September. I'm seeing the 24th to the 30th. Thank you, Michael. 24th to the 30th of September, the last week of September. I feel that you're going to be communicating with this Queen of Swords, Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, or somebody who can be a bit defensive, can be a bit cold, but she's only moved into the Queen of Swords because she's been hurt countless times. You know, this is a woman who's kind of had enough. She's got a steel cage around her heart for protection. She's not normally naturally like that. She's had to defend herself. So you're speaking to this woman, and I feel what you're actually wanting to say, Pisces, is, look, I'm not totally divorced. I'm not totally out of my situation I'm in. But I am legally separated. My partner knows that we're separated. We're not moving into divorce because financially it's going to take too much money to actually get out of this legally. But I want to spend my life with you. I love you. I want to be with you. I've realized you're my Ten of Cups. The problem is, I think this is a woman who feels that it's simply not enough. It's simply just not what she wants. And so you go from feeling all happy and, you know, fingers crossed, I hope that this Queen of Swords says yes. You're a bit nervous, but you're moving towards her to have this conversation. But whatever she says causes you to shift into the Ten of Swords, which could be, oh my goodness, I really thought that there was a potential that she would say yes, because I'm legally separated from my partner. We are not living together anymore. We are not connected anymore in that emotional way. My ex-partner's fully aware that we are no longer a couple, but it's simply not enough, Pisces. So you're facing the Ten of Swords. Now, it could also be that this is you having had a bit of a backlash from the person that you've legally separated from. It could be a mixture of defensive energy from the woman that you want to be with, a bit of revenge energy for the woman that you're leaving, and so you're sat in the Ten of Swords. You've realized that by going halfway house has actually caused you a lot of pain. Because neither woman is very happy. The woman that you're leaving is not able to get a divorce settlement, for instance, so she can't actually be free to move on to be with anyone else, because she may be still codependent on you financially. The woman that you're wanting to be with is angry and upset because she could never marry you, or you could never propose to her because you are still legally married to your ex karmic. And she feels that you're simply, Pisces, maybe being a little bit selfish in not really wanting to totally detach. You're kind of going halfway house. You're realizing that you've actually made both women quite upset. And that's why you're sitting in the Ten of Swords. Because you're not able to be happy either way. What you're fearing is the King of Cups in reverse. Fearing that this is going to make you all emotionally unbalanced, really stressed out. You're also fearing, Pisces, that yes, you'd have to admit to yourself, I have been emotionally a little bit deceptive. I know I have, because I didn't really want to lose the money going through a divorce, but I didn't really want to be with my ex karmic anymore. So I know I'm not totally ending my past situation and I want to be with this other woman. And I think you're fearing the King of Cups in reverse, because this is what you might have anticipated, hence the fear. You might have anticipated backlash from your karmic partner, and a lot of defensive energy from the woman that you want to be with. So this is you rethinking, Pisces. What do I do now? I'm sat in the Ten of Swords. My karmic partner's pissed off and angry because she expected a divorce settlement and I'm not giving her that. The woman I want to be with is defensive and angry because she knows I'm still legally connected to my karmic partner. I'm not winning at all. So you're going to be retreating, Pisces, and you're going to be thinking about things, maybe for a couple of months. After this conversation, which is going to be painful, it's going to be difficult, you're going to have to kind of pick yourself up a bit. What you're hoping is with the energy of the Fool in reverse, either to completely release an Aries, could be an Aries woman that you're married to, okay, I've got to do it, or you're realizing that you just can't do anything risky. Particularly now, your ex-karmic's on edge, the woman that you want to be with is annoyed and upset. You just can't afford, if you're going to sort of save the situation, you can't afford to do anything foolish. You've got to really think carefully about the next step. Otherwise, you burned both bridges. Okay? You burned both bridges. The outcome is the Magician. Now, I like the Magician because it's not in the reverse. This is not you trying to be manipulative, Pisces. This is actually you realizing that you do have all the tools you need in order to create the outcome that is going to be fair and just for everyone involved. You may be needing to have a serious sit-down conversation with a Virgo, Scorpio, or Gemini. Or this is you moving into the Magician energy. I know I can sort this out. I know I can do this. What I think you're realizing, Pisces, is that with the Five of Swords, by you kind of not really doing the right thing, I mean, this is going to get what you want, but you're hurting people behind you. This is a little bit of my way or the highway. This is a little bit of, you know, I'm just going to go and get what I want to get. I don't really care what people think. You've caused yourself and other people around you a lot of heartbreak. Because let's face it, your Queen of Swords is pissed off and angry. Your karmic partner has not got the nice, comfy divorce settlement that she was hoping for to move on and live the rest of her life to meet somebody else. And you are sat in the Ten of Swords. So by you actually sitting in the Five of Swords, you've caused not only other people a lot of hurt and pain, but yourself too. Now, this could be a little bit of karma, could be. But what you're realizing, Pisces, masculines, is that you're very unhappy without this Queen of Swords. Even though she's being defensive and putting her boundaries up, you may feel deep down, Pisces, that she's right. Okay. Well, if I was in her position, I'd probably do the same. I probably wouldn't be very happy with what I'm offering me, right? So here we have the Nine of Swords. Now, I think this is you realizing that by trying to go halfway house has caused a lot of upset for everyone involved, including yourself. So this is you thinking about things, very unhappy, trying to figure out what to do, very stressed, feeling alone. You're realizing that your karmic partner is really wanting a clean start. So she's wanting a proper divorce settlement so she can carry on with the rest of her life. Otherwise, she is connected to you, which means that she can never move forward to be with anyone else. Your Queen of Swords is very upset with the idea of you still being legally married to another woman, but saying to her, I want to live with you. Well, it's not enough. So with the Nine of Swords, you've realized that you've actually alienated yourself from both women. Now, for many of you, you won't worry too much that you've alienated yourself from your karmic partner. But if you've made her pissed off and angry by saying, well, we'll separate, but I'm not giving you a divorce settlement, she's going to be cross. And it may well be that if you then move into a divorce process, she's going to make things very difficult for you, Pisces, because underneath, she's angry and upset that you didn't offer her divorce settlement to begin with. You've made her wait. So here we have the Queen of Cups in reverse. I think this is the energy that relates to both women. Okay? I think that whoever you're leaving, and you could be leaving a Cancerian woman or an Aries, whoever you're leaving is very unbalanced and upset. Because she may feel, well, okay, Pisces, you're leaving me, but the least you could do is to allow me to move on with my life, to be with somebody else, allow me to be a completely free woman, and to provide me with a decent divorce settlement. But you haven't done that. What I think you're saying to your karmic partner is, we're legally separating, it's over and done with, I will give you a monthly allowance. But she's upset because she's still tied to you. Your Queen of Swords can also be sitting in the Queen of Cups in reverse. She could be a Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, or an Aquarius, Libra, Gemini. She's upset that you would have thought that she would accept your offer. It's almost as if, would you really think that that would be enough for me to say yes with you still being a legally married man? I don't think so. So she's upset. She's upset. So this is a no-win situation, but you're sitting in the energy of the Magician. You can sort this out. And what I think you're going to do, Pisces, is following you, sat in the King of Pentacles in reverse. I'm still a married man. I don't really want to get divorced because I'd be putting myself in a situation where my finances would be unstable. But with this card in this position, what you Pisces are looking at is, so I'm going to remain married, but I really want to be in the Ten of Cups. So I want to be with this Queen of Swords. She's my Ten of Cups, but I don't really want to get divorced because I'd lose money. Okay. What you're realizing, Pisces, is that is not working. That's not working. Everyone around you is upset, including you, because you're in the Ten of Swords. So with the Two of Swords, you didn't really want to have to make a serious decision. What you're realizing is, I do love this Queen of Swords, despite her being angry and upset. And I think I've got to make a decision to do the right thing. This is you finally making a firm decision. You're taking off the blindfold, you're accepting the truth, and you're realizing I do have to make a clean cut. So this is what you're doing. Knight of Pentacles is you maybe moving into divorce, giving your karmic partner a divorce settlement that she can use to move on and have a happy life with somebody else, so she's not legally tied still to you. You are then going to offer a proper committed relationship to this Queen of Swords. That, I think, is what you're going to do, Pisces. Okay? All right, people. It's been quite a reading so far, guys. Let's jump in and see where this goes. Archangel Michael, what is the energy, please, of the Chariot in the reverse crossed with the Ace of Swords? Four of Swords. So this is you, Pisces, feeling all heartbroken, all stressed. I'm in love with another woman, but I'm married to somebody else. You are deciding to take action. You're stressed about it, but you are traveling, I think, to see someone, to have a conversation with them about moving into the Ten of Cups. But with the Eight of Pentacles at this point, and this may be now-ish time, okay, you haven't completely ended your long-term situation. You're still in it. There could be a lot of finances involved, wrapped up in the marriage, whether it's in a property, whether it's just because you're married. So you're taking action to be happy, but you know that you are, at this point of time, still legally married. Even if you've legally separated from your partner or you don't live with your partner anymore, you're still married for financial reasons. Okay? So you're moving forwards, I think, towards this Queen of Swords. Yes, because with the Ace of Cups, you want love. You want love in your life. You want to move into the Ten of Cups. I'm unhappy in my long-term situation. It's just there as financial security for me, but I want to be happy. So you're heading towards the person that you want to be with. Knight of Swords, yes. So this is you, Pisces. You could have Aquarius, Libra, Gemini in your chart. This is you moving towards somebody pretty quickly to have a very straight conversation with them, which entails that you want to be with your Queen of Swords in the Ten of Cups. So, Michael, why is Pisces, my Pisces masculines, thinking about the Ten of Cups? Page of Cups, yes. So, it could well be that whoever this woman is pushed you away in the past and you had no option but to hold yourself back from her. You've now decided to maybe move into legal separation and you're wanting, with the Ten of Cups, to apologize to your Queen of Swords. I'm so sorry it took me this long to decide what to do, but you are my Ten of Cups. I want to be with you. I want to be with you. What else is Pisces saying? Three of Wands. So it may well be, Pisces, that you are planning on relocating to live nearer your Queen of Swords. You know, I'd do as much as move to your area to live with you, to make it really work so we can have a brand new life. You're very excited about this. You're hoping that you are doing enough in terms of changing your situation to make this Queen of Swords say yes. That is what you're hoping for. Okay. Michael, what is the Queen of Swords? Now, this is the person that you're approaching, okay? This is the woman that you're going to be talking to. Yeah. Three of Pentacles in the reverse. Oh, Pisces. What she's basically saying, Pisces, is I do not want to be building a foundation with you if you are still clutching hold of your karmic partner legally, financially. I am not wanting to work on this if this is going to be some kind of third party situation, which of course it still is. What else is she saying? Nine of Cups. You're just coming back to me because you want to have your cake and eat it. You're coming back to me because I give you a lot of happiness. It's the happiness that you want, but you're not offering me what I want. So it's unbalanced. And this is overindulgent. As far as I'm concerned, you're holding a karmic partner well out the way and you're just moving towards me because you say I make you happy. Well, it's not good for me. It's not what I want. Wow. Oh, Pisces, Ten of Wands in reverse. Look at these tens. So what she's doing is swiftly speaking her piece and then saying, see you later, Felicia. This is way too burdensome for me. I do not want to deal with this. I'm turning my back. I'm looking to the future. Good luck. Good luck in finding somebody who will accept that. I'm not going to accept it. It may be a very short, sharp conversation, and it's going to throw you, Pisces, into the Ten of Swords. Oh my God, I didn't realize that this woman would have that stronger reaction to my suggestion. Ooh, okay. What else is on the mind of the Queen of Swords? The karmic partner. Queen of Pentacles. This is known to be the karmic partner. We got the King of Pentacles in reverse, Queen of Pentacles. If you are still linked to a karmic partner, Pisces, she's not accepting your proposal. Now, if this is also her thinking about commitment in the future for herself, she's wanting to be the main woman. She's wanting to be your wife. She's not wanting to be your mistress, because however you flower up your situation, well, I don't live with my karmic partner, we don't love each other, we're not living in the same house, we live miles away, we haven't spoken for 6 months. It makes no difference. The fact is, you are still legally married to another woman. So you can never marry this Queen of Swords. And that's really what she's upset about. You think that I would accept this? What woman would accept that? Ongoing. No way. She has too much respect for herself. How is Pisces feeling at this point of time? Yeah, Pisces, Emperor in the reverse. You know that you're not acting with integrity. You know that you are trying to have things your own way. I mean, this is my way or the highway. This is also a bit manipulative. You could have Aries in your chart. So what you're realizing is that this woman is turning her back. She's turning her back. And Pisces, with the Hangman energy, you are stuck. You don't know what to do. Okay. It's kind of you realizing back to the drawing board, but with the Ten of Swords on your side and with the Ten of Wands in reverse on this woman's side, it's almost as if she's saying, I don't ever want to hear from you again. She may even be insulted that you would imagine that she would accept this. So this is really difficult, Pisces. Okay, really difficult. What is on Pisces' mind? Okay, yeah. King of Wands in the reverse. So Pisces, this is you trying to get away with not really acting with integrity, you know, in the nicest sense. Ace of Pentacles in reverse. You're not offering proper long-term commitment to this Queen of Swords. It may be she even feels that you're trying to get away with pulling her into some kind of affair, ongoing affair, and she's upset. She's upset. What is Pisces thinking about? Okay, as I said, back to the drawing board. Two of Wands, you are now thinking, all right, what do I do now? Because my karmic partner's upset that I've just separated from her. I'm not giving her some kind of financial settlement so she can get on with her life. And my Queen of Swords that I thought was my Ten of Cups is basically angry and pissed off. And she's turned her back on me and said, see you later. So Pisces, you're sat at crossroads thinking, well, I know what to do now. So this is you taking some time to think about things. Okay. What is the overall energy between them both? Yeah, absolutely. Page of Pentacles for me sometimes is signing divorce papers. This is your Queen of Swords knowing that you're not divorced and you not wanting to divorce. So this is not moving forward. So I think Pisces, you're going to retreat and you're going to take a couple of months maybe to think about what to do. Okay. Now, I either completely walk away from my Queen of Swords, but I don't want to because she's my Ten of Cups, she's what I'm hoping for, or I have to bite the bullet and literally move into a full divorce process, maybe to do the right thing, to completely detach from my karmic partner, to give her a good settlement so she's happy, and it would mean that I could then move forward into a lovely situation with my Queen of Swords that would make her happy. But I don't know, because your Queen of Swords has already kind of told you where to go. So you may have upset her twice. Once in maybe pulling her into an affair. Second of all, in suggesting that you two live together because you're still legally married to another woman. So she's really pissed off. It's as if you really wasted my time. I thought at least when you came back to me, you would offer me something realistic. But no. And so she's really pissed off. All right, now, the good news, Pisces, is that you're sat in the energy of the Magician. So what is the energy of the Magician? What is Pisces thinking about? The Sun. Pisces, you simply want to be happy. Now, you could be manifesting a Leo. So this Queen of Swords could be an Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, or a Leo. You're just wanting forward movement, contentment, stability, happiness. You're manifesting happiness. Okay, so what is Pisces going to do? What is Pisces going to do? Yeah, the Devil. Now, if you're in a relationship with a Cancer, a Cancerian, an Aries, or a Capricorn, or somebody with all of that in their chart, you are getting out of what has become a toxic situation. You're also releasing the temptation to sit in your shadow side, which is not really doing the right thing. You're deciding, yeah, I have to really take control of the situation. If I am to be happy, I've got to step into the powerful energy of the Magician to manifest in an upright energy, which is clean manifestation. Okay, pure manifestation, not shadow manifestation, and to release toxic energy. You're realizing that that's what you have to do. So what is Pisces doing? My goodness, you can't make tarot up. Six of Pentacles. So you are dividing the assets. You are realizing, okay, I didn't really want to have to do this because I'm going to have to give money to my karmic partner. And it may be tricky, Pisces. You may not have very much money. but you're realizing that for your future happiness and expansion and growth and progress, you have to detach fully from your previous situation. And I think that's what you're deciding to do. Okay? The Death card. You may be finalizing a situation with a Scorpio, but I think you know you have to end the situation you're in with your karmic partner to transform your life. Yes. Yeah. Moon in reverse. So you're realizing that you have to do the right thing. This is you taking control of your situation and releasing the fear in doing so. You could be releasing a Cancerian with the Moon in reverse. So what is Pisces going to do? Knight of Cups. I think maybe after a few months, Pisces, after this really awkward conversation with the woman that you want to be with, you're going to ride in with a Knight of Cups saying to this woman, okay, I'm really sorry. The only reason why I suggested living together with me still being legally married is that I would lose an awful lot of money. But I realize that if I am going to be happy, if I'm going to have a new life, if I'm going to make you happy, and it's important for me because I love you, you're my Ten of Cups, then I have to do the right thing. I have to release the karmic partner. Wow. So Pisces, this is what you're doing. And with the Six of Wands, Leo energy, it could well be that you feel if you do this, there will be victory and success. This is also you being successful in a court case. Maybe you're realizing at this point that you wouldn't lose as much money as you thought you would. Okay. All right. Well, you may lose 7 out of your 10 pentacles. Okay. But you will still feel as if you've done the right thing. I'm actually, Pisces, in a strange way, getting a pride energy from you. You may look back and think, you know what? I'm proud of myself because I know in my heart of hearts, I've done the right thing. I've done the thing that was all about being honest and open, acting with integrity and being fair. And you will feel proud of yourself. So this is, I think, that energy. It's beautiful. Beautiful, guys. All right, what's going to happen with this connection with the Queen of Swords? Six of Cups. So you're going back to the Queen of Swords again, third time lucky, to say, I've done it. I mean, whether or not this is you proving that you're going through a legal situation or giving this person the date that you'll probably sign the final divorce papers, you're admitting, you're saying, okay, I'm sorry I tried to do the halfway house thing. I was really worried I'd lose all of my money. I will lose quite a lot, but I feel as if it's worth it to be with you for us to have a new life. So Pisces, this is beautiful energy, really lovely energy, okay? Empress in the reverse, what you're saying to this Queen of Swords is, Empress in the reverse, obviously my karmic partner's not very happy. I've had to give her a lot of money because she was codependent on me. But it's in the bag. It's in the process of being sorted out, okay? All right. What final card do we have for my lovely Pisces? The Star. So this is a beautiful wish come true. This is healing a connection. And if you're dealing with a Queen of Swords, she could very well be an Aquarius. Okay? But this is peace after the storm. And this is you coming together with a woman that you feel is going to make you really happy. Finally, Pisces. Oh my goodness, guys. Under the deck, Four of Wands. 11-11. I have to say, with this divine connection here, Emperor and Empress, the Sun, you could be leaving a karmic soulmate behind, Pisces, and moving towards your divine twin, for some of you. All right, now, let's finish with messages from the heart. Let's have a look. These are by Lightworker Tarot and Oracle. Message from my Pisces to their person. I see my future with you. Very simple, Pisces. That's what you want to say to this person. Second message, please. Second message. Second message. That one flipped. That one, okay. I've never felt such an intense connection. Yeah. So Pisces, you are doing the right thing because you can't imagine your life without this other woman. And I think you are going to be doing the right thing because you want to move into the Four of Wands, which is living together, setting up house, and being very happy. This is also engagement. So you two could be getting engaged in the future. So guys, I'm leaving it there. A challenging reading, but I hope that's helped. Sending love and light your way as always, and many blessings. Bye, Pisces.